Welcome to my channel on numerical methods in civil engineering. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest update. Okay, so let us continue the Simpson's rule. Okay, so in the last class, in the previous class, we were doing a problem on trapezoidal rule. Okay. So this was the prismoidal rule. So in the prismoidal rule, as I told you, actually it is same till the end. Okay, calculation of the bending moments and finding out the moment at x, everything is same as strength of materials. Only what the thing which is differing from previous one is actually you will be calculating. This also will be same. You will be calculating the bending moments according to m. equation. Only difference will be using the Simpson's formula for finding the areas. That's it. So you can use this formula. That's nothing but h by 3 into y naught plus 4. Y naught will be the starting ordinate. The second ordinate will be 4 times, and the third ordinate will be 2 times. So even ordinates will have 4 times, and add ordinate will have what, twice. Okay, so that will continue till yn. So this will be the formula for finding out the total area below the curve. Okay, it can be bending moment diagram or any other applications. Okay, and in the previous class, actually we had solved. I mean, I had explained for a general problem with a general Q and L as the length. Okay, now let us take the same. I mean, similar example of calculating the area. Okay. We'll take the same example, but we'll assume some value. Okay, so W is equal to 60 and L is equal to 12 meter. All of you can able to see the screen, right? Everyone. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So what we will do? Actually, we had solved the same problem using trapezoidal rule, right? So 60 and 12. Let us calculate the area by Simpson's rule as well and compare between the two. Okay, and we can feel the difference between them. Okay, so this is the Simpson's rule, and so for demonstration purpose. And one more thing is, from today's class, I'll be explaining how you need to solve the problem using MS Excel. And also, I'll be giving you, later, I'll be giving you, each one of you, some examples which you need to supposed to solve by using MX Excel as well. That will be considered as LEA2. Okay. So, all of you clearly understand. And if you have any doubt, you can let me know. Right. Okay. So, now what we will do, we will consider the simply supported beam with UVL, okay, just like this, right? 60 and 12, and this is actually for trapezoidal rule. Okay, this we have calculated. I mean, the area has been calculated by using trapezoidal rule. Okay, so I'll just rename here. Now what I'll do I'll take the same problem, and we will modify for Simpson's rule. Okay, I'll from the beginning, I'll create the same problem using Simpson's rule. Okay, let us create a new sheet like this. Simpson UVL, I can say SS UVL. I'd given the name. So what in MS Excel, what you should do is you have to create such a way that users, whoever use this Excel, they should be able to understand that. Okay. So now I'll copy this figure here. Okay, because the same thing is applicable. Same figure will be there. Okay. I'll copy this. Copy here. Now what you have to do is we need to give some space for inputting the W and L. So let us consider, actually this is small W. Whatever is, this W is the total load. Okay, that's nothing but the total load. So W is equal to enter, is equal to enter, and you have to give some value here. You have to enter here. So what we can do, we can just give some color and mention that this indicates the input, indicates are the spaces for inputting the data. Okay, so here you should input the value of, and you can also comment here. Okay, a new comment, input the W value or intensity of UVL, intensity of UVL. So one whoever uses this will be able to know what's actually it is there here. You can see here, input the intensity of UVL, just it will come like that. Okay, so that you can understand, anybody can understand. Next, length L, and equal to sign if you use, you cannot just go like that, otherwise it will take it. So it will take for the calculation, equal and press enter, then only it will come out of that. The other formatting and other things you can do it, and similarly you can mention here. So, and you can comment as well, right click, new comment, enter the length, enter the length of the beam. Okay, just like this, and that's how you can do it. So enter the length of the beam and enter the intensity. So using this, now what we need to do, we need to calculate bending moment at different intervals. Okay, so for that, what we need to have is the formula. Okay, the bending moment value formula, and go back to this. Okay, this is the formula for bending moment at x, m at x. Okay, so use this and you can paste it here somewhere, you keep it outside. Okay, and so we can put it over here. Now what we need to do, so there is here actually it's nothing but, okay, I'll just change this to Q. Okay, that's nothing but intensity of UL, or you can, anything you can do it, any number you can give, any letter you can give. So what are the things inputted here is Q, L and X. Only three values are necessary. So what we will do, we will create some table. Okay, we'll create the X value. So you will have to enter the X in meters. Okay, all of you are able to understand, everyone, X in meter, and that's it. Okay, and this is bending moment, bending moment at X. So because this Q is constant, length L is constant, only the values which are changing are X values. Okay, so X values will give intervals. Okay, because let us calculate the bending moment values at an interval of 1 meter. Okay, 1 0 1, and you know how to drag and fill down the data. Okay, so you can click here, and because the length is 12 meter, you can see the what is the length given in the problem, it's 12 meter. Okay, so create up to 12. Now we should initiate the calculation. So is equal to the formula says Q L square into this is the thing. And now what do? You select this data. Okay, I'll enter the data here in the beginning. So Q is 60 and L is 12. Okay, enter the data. Now here, so is equal to, you should not actually enter the value here. You should instead specify the data. Okay, the link. Okay, so that's the name of the cell, which is nothing but I2. Okay, into, so that's nothing but Q into L into L square. Okay, into one more time L into this whole thing, open the bracket, 1/4. I can just enter 0.25, so that it will be simpler. Into, open the bracket, so X by L, X is nothing but this is the one, X divided by what is L, this is the value of L. Okay, and minus 1/3. Okay, 1/3, 0.33, it will be very approximate. Instead, what I'll do, I'll enter 1/3 only. 1/3 into X by L. Again, this is the X value divided by L, the whole cube. Okay, so the power 3, close the bracket and enter. So you'll get the bending moment value as zero. And so the very advantage of this using MS Excel is you can easily drag it down and you can see the value. But now you can see the answer is not coming. What is the reason? Can anybody tell me? We had mentioned all the values properly, right? What is the problem? Hello, are you there, anybody?
Sir, screen kaanistilla, sir.
Sir, the PPT alla ide, sir. Excel sheet bandilla.
Ah, howda? Okay, okay. Niu adrinda aaglinda helbekittallamma. ಎಷ್ಟು ಹೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ನಾನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಓಕೆ ಒನ್ ಟೂ ತ್ರೀ ಸೊ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಸೊ ಶೇರ್ Yeah, are you able to see now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you should have told me long before. Okay. Now what I'll do, I mean, from the beginning I'll do. So actually, you know, I'll show you how we have done for trapezoidal rule. So this is the trapezoidal rule for, problem. Okay. So I'll do it from the beginning. No problem. Okay. So what you need to do is you need to create one new file. SSUVL, okay, Simpson rule. Simpson, I'll just mention. So in order to solve any problem, what do you think, thing which is necessary is users should understand what you are doing it, okay? So you just copy paste the necessary sketches and figures and illustrations so that the people who are using your program which you have developed should be able to understand what is it. Okay, so this is the one. Now what we will do, we need to mention the input data. Okay, so what are the input data which are necessary? Those are nothing but this Q. Okay, Q and length L. Okay, so here you can paste it here. Can go here. Yeah, so you can place that Q also wherever necessary. Yeah, this is the value of Q, place of Q. So there should be some input area. You can just demarcate that. Okay, input area. Okay, you can have some labels. Okay, where people should be able to clearly understand what is it. Merge center. And if you wanted to have it as a bigger one, you can do it. Okay. What are the things which are required? Q. Okay. The value of Q is necessary. And length L is necessary. The X values afterwards, we need to do it. Okay. So you can make this bigger as well. All of you can able to see the screen right now. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So these are the values of Q and L. Now, Q is equal to, you just need to mention, Q is equal to, press enter. Otherwise, it will take for calculation. So now I've entered, given the equal to sign. And if I click other sign, so it will take calculation. No, it's not required. Just it is for representation purpose. Okay. So just equal to enter and equal you type and press enter so that it will come out of the calculation. And you just mention, you just give some color over here. So that the people can understand the input is necessary here. And you can label here at the side over here. Please input the data in. Please input data here. Okay. So, and if you want additional comment also you can give. Click here, right click, new comment. So you can mention, enter the intensity of UDL, intensity. Intensity of UVL. Okay, just press enter. Next, similarly, here, what is the value? What should be the comment? Enter the length of the beam. Okay, so just enter. That's it. So people who just keep their you know, by keeping their you know, mouse button, so they would be able to see this you know, comment. Okay, so that way you can give the users better information about how to use this. Next, now actually our purpose is this. Actually, we need to solve by Simpson's rule. That means we need to calculate moment at regular intervals, and then we will have to calculate the area by Simpson rule. So now let us calculate bending moment at x. So in order to have that one, we need to have the formula. Okay, so let us copy, let me copy and paste it somewhere here, okay, adjacent side. So that will serve the purpose, okay, for referring to the bending moment. So you can just say this is bending moment at x, equation for bending m at x equation. Okay, you can just maximize it so that people who uses this will be able to understand that. Okay, m at x equation, this is the one. Okay, or you can keep it here as well, right? Yeah. So next thing is we'll have to calculate for the bending moment at regular intervals. Okay, let us consider interval as I have only 10 minutes. Okay, let me complete. So we need to enter the these values. So this is x, or x value in meters, x in meters, because we need to calculate moment at every 1 meter, right? X in meters, and this is bending moment at x, bm at x. Okay, so we need to have interval 0, 1. So you can know, you know how to fill down, right, in Excel. So till 12. So what you have to do, you enter two values, and then clicking the corner of this bottom button, you can drag. Since our length is 12 meters, so the value of q given is in the problem 60, and the length is 12 meter. So you'll be creating x intervals till 12. Next, bending moment at x is equal to, you can initiate the formula, and all of you know how to calculate, right? Is equal to q, you refer to this, into l square, into l, again into l, and again into, you can just open the bracket, into 0.25, open the bracket, x divided by l, x divided by, x is nothing but this is the value here, and divided by L is this is the value. Okay, close the bracket, minus 1/3, 1/3, close the bracket, star, into x by L, x is this, okay, mention this is the value of x, into divided by L, this is the value of L, close the bracket, and to the power 3. Okay, so that is the bending moment at x equation. Okay, so it is taken. So this is all, and afterwards you need not enter all the values. You need not type the formula again and again for all these values. You just need to drag it down by clicking that, but even then the value is not coming. Okay, so the reason, what is the reason? Now you can tell me. So till that time I was explaining earlier, till this I had explained earlier. Yeah, so what is the reason, anybody? Actually, if I drag it down, it has to update itself. What is the problem? It's not getting updated. You can see here. So the first value, it is all correct. X and L, everything is okay. If I drag it down, the second thing, it has taken this and this. Okay, it will automatically move. So what you need to do is you need to make this absolute. Okay, Q and L absolute. There are several methods. In this class, I'll be explaining by one method. What you can do is you can define this area as Q and L. Okay, by doing this, go to formulas. Okay, define name you can give, and just type Q. And what is that value of Q? You just need to mention. You click here, and go here. Click here. Okay, and just click OK. So it will automatically taken that Q value. I'll show you very easy how easy it will be. Now select this. Go to define name. And automatically it will be taken this, okay, and type it as what is the value, length L, okay, and just click OK. Okay, maybe it will be there. So I'll just give it as maybe already it is there. The name I've given it in the some other sheet. I'll give it as let's say length only I'll give, or le I'll give. Okay, so that will be simpler. And now what you need to do is here, instead of typing this J3 and all, so you can directly type the formula. So I'll show you. Q star LE, okay, LE into LE, okay, open the bracket, 0.25 into X by L. So X is to be, X cannot be defined because it's varying, right? So into X divided by L, LE. Okay, close the bracket, minus, open the bracket, 1 divided by 3, close the bracket, into X by L. X is, you have to mention here, and divided by L, LE. Okay, close the bracket, hold to the power 3. I mean, not, so again, close the one bracket. Yeah. Oh, okay, just enter. LE, H9. Q star, this into, you need to mention. So you should not miss out that multiplication, and you can see automatically the values have come. Okay, so actually speaking, that formula is applicable for till the center. Okay, you can up to 6 meter the formula is applicable. Okay, and the remaining 6 meter will be actually it's a symmetrical thing. Okay, so what you need to do, at 6 meter this is the value, at 7 meter is equal to 5th meter only you can enter, is equal to 4th, and then is equal to 3, is equal to 2, is equal to this, is equal to this. Okay, this formula is applicable till the center. Okay, the values, right? So this is how you can generate Benjamin x. Now what you need to do, calculate the area. Okay, I have only 3 minutes left. So area is equal to, simply I'll do it, area, so is equal to, what is the formula? So we need to copy paste it over here. Okay, the formula for area using Simpson's rule is, copy paste it over here. Copy, paste it here. So now what is the formula? H by 3, you can go on giving the value. So H is nothing but 1. Okay, so is equal to 1 divided by 3, close the bracket. Okay, so y naught is, this one is y naught, plus 4 times y1. Okay, plus 2 times this 2 star, you can just give 2 star y2, plus 4 times this 4 into, I need to give 4 into this, plus 2 into 2 star this, plus 4 star this, plus 2 star multiplication, 2 into this, plus 4 into this, plus 2 into this, plus 4 into this, plus 2 into this, plus 4 into this, plus the last one, just it will be closing, just close, enter. So 5400 is the area that is there in square meters. Okay, but let us compare this value with the trapezoidal rule. What do you expect? Will it be higher or lesser? Anybody? Hello?
Higher value, sir.
Will you expect trapezoidal rule value higher or lesser?
Lesser, sir.
Lesser. Why?
Just assume, sir.
Yeah, not assumption, because there is a reason. So it will be definitely lesser only, because there will be curve over here like this. Okay, there will be curve which will be going, but these straight lines will be within. You can see here, in case of trapezoidal rule, what actually happens, we will be considering the triangles inside. Okay, whereas this Simpson's rule assumes exact curve. So hence it will be you can see here, in the trapezoidal rule we will be assuming the curves inside. Okay, so you will be assuming the lines inside, so you will be leaving out some area, whereas in Simpson's rule we will be considering exact curve. Hence you will be getting almost correct answer. Okay, this is trapezoidal rule, whereas this is Simpson's rule answer. 5400 is the exact answer, you can see. Okay, so this is how you should calculate the areas. Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates.